By the end of this video, you'll understand why switch statements can be a bad sign in your code, how they create technical debt, and what better alternatives exist to keep your code clean, maintainable, and future-proof. Imagine a world where every decision in life had to be made through one massive flowchart. It's 8 a.m. and you need to decide what to have for breakfast. But before you do, you're standing in front of this giant wall filled with hundreds of options, all organized like a massive switch statement. You start reading. If you're hungry and you like eggs, go to case 3. If you're hungry but hate eggs, jump to case 8. You keep reading through dozens of options just to find out what you're having. Here's even a case for if you accidentally leave the milk out overnight but still want cereal. Great. You know there's got to be a better way. But in this world, every decision, no matter how small, is stuck in this endless switch logic. Want to change what you eat tomorrow? Oh, gotta rewrite the half the chart. And if someone else wants to add an option like pancakes, it's chaos. They have to insert their logic at exactly the right spot or the whole system breaks. Can you imagine the mess? And here's where the plot twist hits. The entire system crumbles because someone just added a new case for vegan gluten-free protein pancakes, and the chart can't handle it. It's like one massive domino effect and breakfast becomes impossible. Turns out, this world is the nightmare of messy code. It's a place where switch statements run wild, making even the simplest decision overly complex, impossible to change, and prone to collapse when something new gets added. Scary, right? Okay, now let's take this back to our world in code. Switch statements seem straightforward. You've got conditions, you need different actions, you throw in a switch, boom, problem solved, right? Wrong. That's what everyone thinks, until they see what happens when they grow. The problem with switch statements is that they start off small and manageable, but they grow fast. It's like adopting a cute puppy that turns into Clifford the big red dog overnight. One developer adds a few cases, then another dev comes along, adds a few more, and suddenly you've got 30 cases in one block. Good luck finding the one bug buried in case 27. So why is this a code smell? It's not just about the size, it's about maintainability and extensibility. Every time you need to make a change, you're risking the whole structure. It's fragile, and one wrong condition, and suddenly other cases are affected, and you've got bugs sneaking in. Debugging? Oh, that's going to be a whole weekend project. Not to mention, these giant switch statements usually mean we're breaking one of the most important principles in software design. Open-close principle from solid.
The code should be open for extension, but closed for modification.
Switch statements? They're the opposite. You want to add new functionality? You have to go in, modify the whole thing, and hope it doesn't break anything else. So if switch statements are bad news, what's the fix? Well, instead of throwing everything into a single switch block, you can break it up using polymorphism. Here's the fancy part. By using the design patterns like strategy or factory, you can create a structure where new behaviors are easily added without touching the core code. Each case becomes its own object or method, and voila, you've got a clean, maintainable setup. Let's say you're building a simple game, and you want a bunch of different enemy types that each behave differently. Instead of cramming all of that logic into one switch block like a sandwich made from everything in your fridge, you create a base enemy class and then extend it for each type. Flying enemy, walking enemy, boss enemy, each class handles its own behavior. No switch required. This approach keeps your code base clean and adheres to the single responsibility principle. Need to add a new enemy type later? No sweat. Just create a new subclass. No digging through a massive block of cases and no risk of breaking everything else. Switch statements aren't inherently evil, but when they get out of hand, they reek. They signal that your code is too rigid, that it's not ready for change. And trust me, there's one thing every dev knows, is that change is inevitable. So next time you see one, think about alternatives. Polymorphism, strategy pattern, or even splitting up logic into smaller, modular functions, your future self and probably the next dev stuck maintaining your code will thank you.